Having infertility is stressful. Participating in fertility treatments like IVF is stressful. But does psychological stress reduce the chance for IVF success? Does stress reduction improve the odds of IVF success? Okay, infertility patients, I want you to tell me how many times you have heard this. All you have to do is relax and you will get pregnant. Put it in the comments. It is a really insulting statement which ignores the fact that infertility is a disease just like diabetes or cancer. Measuring psychological stress is tricky. In general, there are two methods. The first method is easy. Ask a person if they feel stress or not. This is known as perceived stress. You can get a little more complicated by having them complete more extensive questionnaires or surveys which calculate stress scores. The second method involves the measurement of hormones or other markers in the blood. In the studies I am going to talk about today, they all used one or both methods to measure stress. Many studies have shown that couples with infertility exhibit high levels of stress. Studies of women undergoing IVF treatment have shown that stress increases as the treatment progresses. Stress levels peak right before the egg retrieval, but then decrease between the retrieval and the transfer. IVF is stressful, no big shock there, but does stress encountered during IVF make it less likely for women to become pregnant? A few small studies performed in the 1990s and early 2000s gave mixed results. I am going to talk about them later. The first really large and well-done study was published in 2009 in the Netherlands. In this study, 783 women from 5 different IVF centers undergoing their first attempt at IVF completed questionnaires to determine their level of anxiety and depression. They found no difference in the chance for the IVF cycle to be canceled before completion and no difference in the chance for pregnancy. This was true whether they measured their stress before treatment started or right before the egg retrieval. Conclusion of study number one, stress had no impact on IVF success. Another large study from Sweden was published in 2017. This study looked at nearly 500 women and not only measured perceived stress, but also a hormone called cortisol, which commonly goes up during times of psychological stress. This study also found no relationship between stress and pregnancy rates. They also failed to find any link between stress and egg quality or embryo quality. Remember earlier when I said there were a bunch of smaller studies on this topic and that the results were mixed? This means that some of those smaller studies showed stress had a negative impact on pregnancy rates and some did not. Smaller studies are more difficult to interpret because they have more statistical uncertainty. One way to be able to make more definitive conclusions is to combine the data from the smaller studies into one larger study. This is called a meta-analysis. If you follow this channel, you know that I talk about meta-analyses a lot. This meta-analysis looked at 14 different studies about psychological stress and IVF pregnancy rates. When they combined all of the data, there were over 3,500 IVF patients included. This study also concluded that psychological stress did not reduce the likelihood of pregnancy with IVF. The best available evidence proves that stress does not lower your chance for IVF success. In other words, don't stress about stress. Should you enroll in some sort of stress reduction program anyway? It depends on why you're doing it. If you are trying to simply improve your chance for pregnancy, then I would say no. Studies like this one have found that coping and relaxing interventions did not improve the chance for pregnancy. On the other hand, if stress is producing adverse effects like anger, lack of sleep, or depression, then by all means, do whatever you can to reduce stress. Other than cost and time, there is probably little downside, so why not? Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.